Welcome back, dear students. In our last class, we learned about continuity of a function at a particular point, right? So, what is the definition? If we say that the function f of x is said to be at x is equal to a, it has to satisfy three conditions, right? The first condition is f of a is defined. F of a is defined. So, what is the meaning of f of a is defined? Means, for example, I consider 1 by x minus 5. This is the given function. At x is equal to 5. At x is equal to 5 means replace the value x by 5, right? So, it becomes 1 minus 5 minus 5. 1 by 0. 1 by 0 is infinite. It is not defined. So, this is not a continuous function. So, continuous means the first condition is f of a is defined at that point. So, here at x is equal to 5, the given function is not defined. So, for example, 1 by 2 minus x at x is equal to 1. So, 1 by 2 minus 1, that is 1 by 2. Sorry, 2 minus 1 is 1, that is equal to 1. So, the given function is defined at x is equal to 1, right? Defined means we get some finite value. Then only we say that the given function is defined at a particular point. So, this is the first condition, okay? The first condition is the given function is defined at the given point, okay? The second condition is limit. Limit x tends to a, f of x exists. The limit of the function must exist. This is the second condition, which means for left hand limit and right hand limit exist and both are equal. This is the second condition. And the third condition is f of a is equal to limit extends to a f of x, which means the both the values must be equal. If the given function satisfy all these three conditions, then we say that the given function is continuous at x is equal to a. For example, at x is equal to 2, if we say that the given function f of x is said to be continuous, the first condition f of 2 is exist defined at that point, and limit x tends to 2 f of x is exist, and f of 2 must be equal to limit of the function, that is limit x tends to 2 f of x. So I already said that limit means left hand limit and right hand limit exist and they must be equal. So it is nothing but f of 2 is equal to left hand limit is equal to right hand limit. If this condition is satisfied, then we say that the given function is continuous at 2. Okay. So this is we already know in our last class. So using this condition, today I am going to solve some problems, and these problems are very very important problems for 4 marks. So in your part E, so you have 10 marks question. In that you have 2 options, 2 questions, 6 marks and 4 marks, right? So in that 4 marks you will get this type of questions. So this is very important problems for 4 marks. So the problem is find the value of k so that the function f is continuous at x is equal to 2, and the function is given by f of x is equal to kx square if x is less than or equal to 2 and 3 if x is greater than 2. So we already say that the given function, this function is continuous at x is equal to 2. So we have to find the value of this k. Okay. So what is the first condition? F of here a is equal to 2. So first we have to find f of 2. So here we have two types of functions. So if this function is the value of x is less than or equal to 2, the given function is equal to kx square, and the value is greater than 2, the function becomes 3. Okay. So f of 2 means here x is equal to 2, right? So x is equal to 2 means the function is what? K into x square. So f of x is equal to kx square. F of 2 means we replace x by 2. So it becomes k into x means 2 square. the limit of the function must exist. So if you consider left hand limit, so left hand limit means we remember that for left hand limit, so at x is equal to 2, so we have to find the limit. So this is x at x is equal to 2. So left hand limit means, so we approach to x tends to 2 from left side. So for right hand limit, x tends to 2 means we approach 2 from right side. So here these are all values less than 2, right? So this here the values are greater than 2. So therefore for left hand limit we have to consider the function which is less than the given function, given point. So for right hand greater than, so right hand limit find out not by kandre x is greater than in the yodhita, we have to consider this one. For left hand limit less than in the yodhina consider marbeko, okay na? So now we have to find left hand limit and right hand limit, right? So if you consider left hand limit, we have to choose this function, right? So again we get this answer. So we using this we can't find the value of k. So therefore our right hand limit, so find right hand limit. So definition is limit x tends to 2 plus f of x. So limit x tends to 2 f of x. For right hand limit we have to consider the function is greater than 2. For greater than 2 the value is 3. So x tends to 2 means here we don't have any variable x. So the answer is 3. So this is right hand limit. So given, since the given function is already, we told that the function is continuous. Since the function is continuous, so we already know that if the function is continuous, f of a is equal to left hand limit is equal to right hand limit. So now we have these two values. So since the function is continuous, f of, here a means what, f of 2 is equal to right hand limit. So f of 2, what is the value of f of 2? 4 into k is equal to right hand limit is 3. So when you simplify, k is equal to, we get 3 by 4. This is the value of k. Okay. So I explain once again. So given that, find the value of k so that the function f is continuous. The given function is already continuous at 2 and the function is kx square if x is less than or equal to 2 and 3 for x is greater than 2. First we find f of 2. So given either x is equal to 2, so therefore find f of 2. X is equal to 2 means we have to consider this one, k into x square, replace x by 2. So 2 k into 2 square, 2 square is nothing but 2 2's are 4, 4 into k, this is f of 2. Next consider right hand limit, this is the definition, limit x tends to 2 f of x, limit x tends to 2, right hand limit means greater than, so x is greater than 2 means 3, so 3, so right hand limit becomes 3. Since the given function is continuous, f of 2 is equal to right hand limit, f of 2 is 4 into k is equal to right hand limit is 3, so k is equal to 3 by 4, this is the value of k. Okay. So we move on to the next problem. The next problem is find the value of k so that the function f is continuous. So the function f is continuous at x is equal to 5 and the function is given by f of x is equal to kx plus 1 if x is less than or equal to 5. 3x minus 5 if x is greater than 5. So this is similar type of question. Given that the given function is already continuous at x is equal to 5. So the function is kx plus 1 if x is less than or equal to 5. 3x minus 5 if x is greater than 5. We have to find the value of k. So first f of 5. So f of 5 is equal to 5 means we have to consider this one. That is kx plus 1. So k into replace x by 5 plus 1. So 5k plus 1, right? This is f of 5. So now consider right hand limit. So right hand limit, because if you consider left hand limit, so left hand means we have to consider this one, again we get this same value. So I consider right hand limit. So the definition is limit extends to 5 f of x. So limit extends to 5. For greater than right hand limit, we have to consider this function, that is 3x minus 5. So x tends to 5 means replace x by 5. So 3 into 5 minus 5. So 5 3 is 15 minus 5. It is nothing but 10. So since the function or the given, since the given function is continuous, since the given function is continuous, f of 5 is equal to what? Right hand limit, right? What is the value of f of 5? 5a plus 1 is equal to, right hand limit is 10. Now simplify this one. 5k is equal to 10 minus 1. 5k is equal to 10 minus 1 is 9, and the value of k is 9 by 5. So the value of k is 9 divided by 5. Okay. So next problem, find the value of k so that the given function is continuous. Find the value of k so that the function f is continuous at x is equal to pi. At x is equal to pi, and the function is given by f of x is equal to kx plus 1 if x is less than or equal to pi, and cos x if x is greater than pi. So we have to find the value of k. So follow the same procedure. First we have to find f of pi, because they said that the given function is continuous at x is equal to pi. So f of pi is equal to what? Is equal to, we have to consider this one, kx plus 1, replace x by pi. So k into pi plus 1, this is f of pi is equal to k pi plus 1. Now consider right hand limit. So right hand limit, the definition is limit extends to pi plus f of x. Limit extends to pi. So right hand limit, we have to consider this one. So the function is cos x. So now apply the limit. Extends to pi means it becomes cos pi. So what is the value of cos pi? Cos pi is minus 1. So right hand limit is equal to what? Minus 1. Since the given function is continuous. Since the given function is continuous, can I write f of pi is equal to right hand limit? Can we write? So f of pi is equal to what? K pi plus 1 is equal to right hand limit is minus 1. Simplify this one. K pi is equal to minus 1. When this goes to here, it becomes minus 1. So k pi is equal to minus 2. Then k is equal to minus 2 divided by pi. So this is the value of k. K is equal to minus 2 divided by pi. So the next problem, find the value of k. Find the value of k so that the function f is continuous. The function f is continuous at x is equal to pi by 2. Continuous at x is equal to pi by 2, and the function is given by k into cos x divided by pi minus 2x if x is not equal to pi by 2, and 3 if x is equal to pi by 2. So the given function is continuous at x is equal to pi by 2, and the function is f of x is equal to k cos x divided by pi minus 2x when if x is not equal to pi by 2. So if x is not equal to pi by 2, so we have to consider for both left hand limit and right hand limit. So here not less than or equal to, So not equal and if x is not equal to y by 2, the function is equal to k cos x divided by pi minus 2x and 3 if x is equal to pi by 2. So the first condition, that is f of pi by 2. So when x is equal to pi by 2, the value is 3. So f of pi by 2 is equal to 3. So the second condition, that is limit x tends to pi by 2 f of x. So limit x tends to pi by 2. So x tends to pi by 2 means we approach pi by 2 from right side or left side, if it, but x is not equal to pi by 2. For x is not equal to pi by 2, the function becomes this one. So I consider this one k cos x divided by pi minus 2x. So x tends to pi by 2 means if you apply in the place of x pi by 2, k cos pi by 2 divided by pi minus 2 into x means pi by 2. So cos pi by 2 is 0, divided by 2 gets cancelled. Pi minus 2 is also 0. So this is 0 by 0, that is indeterminate form. So we have to remove this indeterminate form, right? So when you put x is equal to pi by 2, when you apply the limit, this becomes indeterminate form. So further, put x is equal to pi by 2 minus h. Okay, when you here we have x tends to pi by 2. If x tends to pi by 2, so x becomes pi by 2 is equal to pi by 2 minus h. Pi by gets cancelled, x tends to what? 0. So I rewrite this. X tends to pi by 2. When x tends to pi by 2, x tends to what? 0. So limit x tends to 0 k into cos. X means what? I put x is equal to pi by 2 minus h. So cos into x means pi by 2 minus h divided by pi minus 2 into x means what? Pi by 2 minus h. Okay. In the next step, limit x tends to 0 k into cos of pi by 2 minus h. We already know that cos of pi by 2, something is cos becomes sine, sine becomes cos. So when you have pi by 2, the trigonometric functions get reversed. Cos becomes sine, sine becomes cos. So cos pi by 2 minus h is sine h. Okay, divided by pi minus. So simplify this one. 2 into pi by 2 minus into minus become plus. 2 into h is 2h. So 2 gets cancelled. So the remaining terms are limit h tends to 0 k into sine h divided by pi. Here also with pi minus pi plus 2h. So plus pi minus pi gets cancelled. So we have limit h tends to 0 k into sine h divided by 2 into h. Right? So we already know that one standard formula, that is limit theta tends to 0 sine theta divided by theta is equal to what? 1. Right? Limit theta tends to 0 sine theta by theta is equal to 1. So similarly we have here sine h by h, limit h tends to 0. In the place of theta we have h. So this becomes what? So this can also be write as, so I write a by 2 outside. So the remaining is limit h tends to 0 sine h by h. So it is nothing but 1. So k by 2 into 1 is equal to what? K by 2. So the limit of the function is equal to k by 2. In the next step, since the function is continuous, since the function is continuous, we can write f of pi by 2 is equal to limit x tends to pi by 2 f of x. Right? This is the definition for continuous. So what is the value of f of pi by 2? 3 is equal to limit value is k by 2. So we want the value of k. Cross multiply this one. So k is equal to what? 3 2s are 6. So this is the value of k. So here in the first step, f of pi by 2, x is equal to pi by 2, the value of the function is 3. So when you find limit of the given function, so I consider this function, when x tends to pi by 2, cos pi by 2 is 0, here also pi by 2, pi minus pi we get, so it becomes 0 by 0, that is indeterminate form. So for that, I put x is equal to pi by 2 minus h. When x tends to pi by 2, it means x is equal to pi by 2, we get h tends to 0. So I replace, we made h tends to 0, k cos of, in the place of x I replace pi by 2 minus h. So here also I replace pi by 2 minus h. So we know that cos of pi by 2 means it converted into sin. So it becomes sin h. So now in the denominator I simplify. So finally we get k sin h divided by pi pi also get cancelled 2h. In the next step, I write k by 2 in the outside, the remaining is limit h tends to 0 sin h by h. We know that limit theta tends to 0 sin theta by theta is nothing but 1. So the whole term is equal to 1. K by 2 into 1 is k by 2. So given what? The function is continuous. So which means f of pi by 2 is equal to limit of the function. F of pi by 2 is 3 and the limit of the function we get k by 2. So the value of k is 3 into 2, that is 6. Okay. So shall we move to the next problem? The next problem is find the value of a and b. The next problem is find the value of a and b which is the given function is continuous at find the value of a and b such that the function is defined by so f of x is equal to find if x is less than or equal to 2 ax plus b if x is 2 less than x less than 10 21 if x is greater than or equal to 10 is a continuous function. So find the value of a and b. The function is defined by f of x is 5 when x is less than or equal to 2. Ax plus b if x is greater than 2 less than 10. And 21 if x is greater than or equal to 10 is a continuous function. The given function is continuous. At which point here we have 2 points at x is equal to 2 and also at x is equal to 10. So we have to find the two values, that is both a and b. So first find at x is equal to 2. Okay, at x is equal to 2, f of 2. What is the value of f of 2? Is equal to means we have to consider this one, right? 5. F of 2 is equal to 5. Then if you consider left hand limit, that is less than, again we get the same answer. So consider right hand limit. So it is nothing but limit x tends to 2 f of x. It is equal to limit x tends to 2 plus. So here we have 2 less than x. It is nothing but x is greater than 2, right? So greater than 2 means we have to consider this for right hand limit. So it is ax plus b. X tends to 2 means apply the limit. When x is equal to 2, we have 2a plus b. Okay. So given that what? The function is continuous. Since the function is continuous, we can write f of 2 is equal to right hand limit. What is the value of f of 2? F of 2 is 5. Is equal to right hand limit is 2a plus b. So call it as equation 1. Similarly, we have another the value is 21. F of 10 is 21. Similarly, if you consider here x is less than 10, this is the function. If x is greater than 10, this is the function. Here, if you consider right hand limit, so we have to consider this one. So we get the same answer. But so here we have to consider left hand limit. Understand? Here f of 10, the function for both greater than or equal to 10 is 21. So if you consider right hand limit, you will get the same answer. So that's why I consider left hand limit. For left hand limit, we want x is less than 10, right? So x less than 10, this is the function. So that's why I consider left hand limit here. So left hand limit is equal to limit x tends to 10 f of x. So limit x tends to 10. What is the function? Ax plus b. So apply the limit x tends to 10 means 10a plus b. This is left hand limit. So also given that the given function is continuous. Since the function is continuous, we can write f of 10 is equal to left hand limit. F of 10 is 21 is equal to left hand limit is 10a plus b. Consider this is as equation 2. So now we have to find the value of a and b. So for that, equation 2 minus equation 1. Equation 2 minus equation 1. So what is equation 2? Equation 2 is, this is 10a. So equation 2, 10a plus b is equal to what? 21. Equation 1 is 2a plus b is equal to 5. So when you subtract means, so chain sign gets reversed. Plus b minus b gets cancelled. 10 minus 2 is 8a is equal to 21 minus 5 is 21 minus 5 is 16. So a is equal to what? 60 divided by 8. 8 ones are, 8 twos are. So a is equal to 2. So we get the value of a. So we need to find the value of b. So consider any equation 1 and 2. I consider this equation and put the value of a, you will get the value of b. So this is equation 1. 5 is equal to 2 into a is 2 plus b. So 5 is equal to 2 twos are 4 plus b. 5 minus 4 is equal to b. So the value of b is 5 minus 4 is 1. So the value of a is equal to 2 and the value of b is equal to 1. So I explain once again. Here we have to find the value of both a and b, and the function is this one. It is continuous at two points, that is at x is equal to 2 as well as at x is equal to 10 also. First, find at x is equal to 2. So, and also since the function is continuous, so f of 2 is equal to right hand limit, then you will get one equation. Similarly, at x is equal to 10, you will find, you will get this equation. So, we have to find a and b, right? So equation 2 minus equation 1, subtract equation 2 by 1, you will get the value of 2. So to know the value of b, take any one equation, equation 1 or 2, substitute the value of a, then you will get the value of b. Okay, this is very important problem. The next problem is, find the value of k. Find the value of k. And the function is, the given function f is continuous. The function f is continuous at x is equal to 0. And the function is given by f of x is equal to 1 minus cos 2x divided by 1 minus cos x. If x is not equal to 0 and k if x is equal to 0. Find the value of k such that the function f is continuous at x is equal to to 0 and the function is equal to 1 minus cos x divided by 1 minus cos x when x is not equal to 0 and k if x is equal to 0. Okay, first we have to find f of 0, right? F of 0 means when x is equal to 0, what is the value? K. Okay, now consider the second condition, that is limit. Limit x tends to 0 f of x. So limit x tends to 0, x tends to means x is not equal to 0. For x is not equal to 0, we have to use this function. So f of x becomes 1 minus cos 2x divided by 1 minus cos x. Okay, when you apply the limit, cos 0, so x tends to 0, cos 0 is 1, 1 minus again cos 0 is 1, so 1 minus 1 0, 1 minus 1 0, again you will get the indefinite form, 0 by 0 form. So we have to simplify this one. How? So limit x tends to 0, 1 minus cos 2x can be written as 2 sin square x. Okay, we already know this formula. Divide by, so 1 minus cos x, here we have 2x, so that's why it becomes 2 sin square x. So 1 minus cos x, often the formula 1 minus cos x can be written as 2 sin square x by 2, right? Now simplify this one, 2 gets cancelled. So limit x tends to 0 becomes sin x divided by sin x by 2 the whole square. Okay, in the next step, limit x tends to 0, sin x can be written as 2 sin x by 2 into cos x by 2. This is also formula, divided by, write this as it is, sin x by 2 whole square. So, okay, so sin x by 2, sin x by 2 gets cancelled. So, limit x tends to 0, so the remaining 2 cos x by 2 the whole square. So it is nothing but limit x tends to 0, 2 square means 4 cos square x by 2. Okay, now apply the limit, x tends to 0. So 4 into cos 0 is 1. So 4 ones are 4. This is the limit. Since the given function is continuous, Since the given function is continuous, so f of 0 is equal to what? Limit x tends to 0 f of x, right? So f of 0 means k is equal to, what is limit? Limit is equal to 4. So this is the value, k is equal to 4. This is the value of k. So in this problem, observe that if x is not equal to 0, this is the function. If x is equal to 0, it becomes k. Already said that the given function is continuous at x is equal to 0. So f of 0 is k. Then find the limit. So this is the function, but if you put x tends to 0, it becomes 0 by 0, indeterminate form. So I simplify this one. 1 minus cos 2x means 2 sin square x. 1 minus cos x means 2 sin square x by 2. 2 gets cancelled. It becomes sin x divided by sin x by 2 the whole square. Sin x is nothing but 2 sin x by 2 into cos x by 2. Sin x by 2 sin x by 2 gets cancelled. The remaining is 2 cos x by 2 the whole square. 2 square is 4 cos square x by 2. Now apply the limit, x tends to 0 means cos 0 is 1. So 4 into 1 is equal to 4. We know that the given function is continuous. We can write f of 0 is equal to limit of the function. F of 0 is k is equal to, the limit of the function is 4. So the value of k is equal to 4. Okay, thank you. We will continue in the next class.